Hello, hello, hello. We're back again. SEA Dota here for WePlay Season 3. The group stages continue. They do continue. We've got another best of one on our hands. A full day of casting for WePlay. I think we've got like 8 matches today. Going to get through them all pretty quickly, though. It's MVP up against TNC. Now, this match I feel is probably one of the most important ones from the SEA group for a long while, actually. Mineski are 4-0. They've already defeated MVP. They've already defeated TNC. Taring are 2-0. They're still having to play up against some of the bigger teams. I think Fnatic is like the final bigger team from SEA that hasn't played just yet. But this match against MVP and TNC, currently they're both middle of the table, but this could dictate who gets up into second place, maybe overtakes Mineski. But at this point, I can welcome in my co-caster Mottpax, because the draft looks pretty interesting so far.
Yeah. Oh, I'm so excited. We've got so many games going on today. We're already starting off with, as you mentioned, a very crucial one in terms of wins. Got to get these good wins up against the better teams, one might say. Some of the more favored ones, some of the guys who are willing to bring it on out when it comes into those final stages of your little preliminaries here. Either way, this draft, we do have the typical kind of drow just being showed up here by MVP Phoenix, but in terms of heroes that are actually going to be in the game, Nature's Prophet, Visage, TNC, we talked about this several times. They always have a plan during the draft. Where you can kind of sense that what they end up with at the end seems like what they wanted at the beginning anyway. Like maybe in this next phase they're going to be getting that Chen. We saw them run over somebody the other day using the Chen, even though it was like the first time they'd even picked it. So if I'm MVP Phoenix, I'm a little worried about that right now. But like Gyro's still in the pool, Witch Doctor's still in the pool, so the tools are definitely still there.
Yeah, it never seems like TNC get fully outdrafted. It always feels like you're saying, they kind of adapt very well to the situations they put themselves into. It's a good mark of a good team. Sometimes they do get a little, gung-ho. They go into these lanes and think, we've won the draft, guys. Let's just go and win the game. But obviously, it's not always quite that easy. As we did see against Mineski the other day, that's probably one of the closer games we've seen from the SEA group stage, was Mineski against TNC. Obviously, they're both pretty bitter rivals from the Philippines. But we'll find out how MVP does here, because currently MVP are 1-1, TNC are 1-2, but MVP, I feel, they've had this sudden kind of swing in terms of drafting style. Like, before we played, they were kind of, standard, they were just, picking regular stuff, and then they got completely shit on by an OD, and they're suddenly like, oh, we've got to pick this hero, guys. Like, OD is a hero we have to pick, and you'll even see here, when I was casting with March, He was always kind of calling out, the draft. Obviously, he used to be their coach. And he's like, right, they'll pick this. It's like an algorithm. He knew what they were going to pick. And now it's completely different. Because before it was like, okay, we'll come back to this in a second. Before it was like, right, first pick Invoker. Then we had Forev's Lone Druid. Kiwo's got his hero. Forev's got his hero. They go to the Witch Doctor for Dubu. And it was all kind of, easy to find out. And there's Witch Doctor for Dubu kind of Radiant still sitting on that normal line. But Chaos Knight for TNC.
Yeah, that's a little bit unusual. And they did go with that gyro ban, so I'm still, are they still like considering a Chen here? Maybe. It is a nice little bit of a setup stun from the Chaos Knight. He's got plenty of damage, even a little bit of minus armor if you're looking for some Roshaning. This guy's been mixed up just a little bit here. He's still quite the hero. He's also one of those heroes, I don't know about you, but I feel like every time I see a Chaos Knight in a game and it goes past like 40 minutes, immediately like the other team, like their win chance drops by like 10 or 15%. Doesn't matter what the current status of the game is, but this hero late game, man, you get some items on top of him, those illusions just become disgusting.
Yeah, it just all becomes about that phantasm, really. It's just, oh god, there's so many Chaos Knights out on the field. Ryu and I were talking the other day about OD and Terrorblade, because Turing picked a Terrorblade into an OD, and we were like, hang on a second. Surely the illusions are just going to die straight up to the OD. But the thing is, if OD doesn't have any items, he can't do anything to the illusions. He just gets run over by the illusions. So even though Chaos Knight, you may think, Phantasm, you're just going to get right-click down, Sandy's Eclipse is going to clear through those illusions. It's not always that simple. When you have what looks like a pretty good early game lane-winning draft here from TNC, CK, once he has the ultimate, you've got the heal bomb from Dazzle as well, minus armor from Medallion on one of these heroes, the Weave, Nature's Prophet probably goes into, an Orchid or a Mech, some kind of utility build. And the final hero going to be the mid here for TNC, and honestly, it's Teehee, it could be anything. But if OD gets crushed in lane, or gets kind of forced into a position where he has to come back into the game, it's difficult for him to do so a lot of the time.
Yeah, and they'll have the Witch Doctor, who's pretty decent in terms of, you know, hanging around that mid lane, TPing in, offering something. Maybe not the Shadow Grave, a Dazzle, not quite as good. I'm wondering if they're thinking about a Lion right now. Kind of one of those classic anti-illusion heroes, but against, you know, Chaos Knight, there's just so many. But of course, Lion being one of the people who can instantly take out too, pretty important. And then even like the low cooldown on Mana Drain can let you maybe even snag up another one. So for now, though, they'll deal with it in a different fashion. And it really is the first massive AoE damage they have. Like Sandy's Eclipse doesn't really do it that much anymore. So you are going to need somebody to try and clean up these illusions. Going to be great up against the pushing Treants as well. I think that's a pretty solid pick here for MVP.
Good mobility as well, seeing as TNC don't have any kind of instant target disables. There's nothing... nothing to keep the Ember locked down too much until Nature's Prophet does get into that Orchid, if that's what he kind of aims for. Now, Teehee's hero pool is immense. I'm just going to kind of leave it at that. You know, he's not limited to any kind of pool of heroes. So, options here for him towards the mid lane against an OD. Usually we kind of see, you know, Razor, Viper, we go back to that kind of style. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure what else we could look at. You know, Death Prophet is still there, potentially. The Klinks is one of Teehee's heroes. Radiant, and I guess Klinks could do decently against an OD. What else do we actually have? The Juggernaut was actually first phase banned by MVP Phoenix just because of how well TNC run it both mid and safe lane. What are your thoughts for a mid hero here?
I don't know, the Invoker is actually still in the pool. I guess it depends on how much you value it. Like, they didn't value it that highly before, and now maybe with further changes to the hero, it's not something they want to look towards. SEA is notorious for their Queen of Pain, but I really like Viper, honestly, out of all the things that I'm seeing here.
Oh, hello.
You know, and then they just pick a Pugna, so who cares? What? You know, YOLO, I guess. Just TNC, Dota. That's the first time they've even picked Pugna this patch.
I've got a feeling they're going to do something interesting.
Pushy?
Here.
Maybe? I don't know.
I kind of feel like they're going to do Chaos Knight Visage mid or something like that and then have like a Pugna Dazzle bot lane. Because TNC do like their dual lanes. I've honestly got this really, really strong feeling they're going to go Chaos Knight mid with an Iron Talon and he's going to go and farm jungle while Visage... No, seriously, while Visage farms mid. They've done this before with other heroes. They might have done it with a CK, which maybe is why I'm thinking of it. But I remember clearly... they did it with a Juggernaut mid for Teehee, and AU had a Disruptor. And what they did was they got Juggernaut the Iron Talon, he stayed mid until like level 2 or 3, and then he went into jungle and he allowed Disruptor to get levels. I mean, he wasn't getting a lot of farm, but they do like to kind of spread their golden experience early on to get fast level 6s on important heroes. So we might see that.
Like, when you ban Io in the second phase, and then you pick Chaos Knight to start off the second phase of picks... you must have something in mind. Not the most common way you see a draft go down. And MVP Phoenix, it's the Enchantress. NA Dota is leaking.
That's
but
a
no,
support Enchantress,
it's just a
though.
Solid hero, honestly. Yeah, it does appear to be the support there. And that's a little bit interesting, because you're wondering, like, how are they going to lane this now? Like, the Ember Spirit, like, who's he going to be up against? I guess if it's just solo Nature's Prophet, that's fine. And... can be okay with minimal support from the Enchantress. You can be like doing a little bit of jungle farming at the same time as like kind of hanging out with that top lane.
If TNC are thinking of running dual lanes, then you could even potentially throw Enchantress aggressively into the Radiant jungle here and have like Void Enchantress dual offlane.
That'd be so... Isn't Void's, you know, not hard enough to deal with already?
Exactly.
Enchantress is the worst, man. Oh my god. That hero, you cannot handle her in the offlane.
Then Witch Doctor Ember up at top. That could work out. Right, let's see. What have we got? Someone just time walked. Someone's zapping around. Forev, poor man's
shield. Forev zipping.
Getting himself down there.
Doesn't he have a ward, though? Why is he in such a hurry?
He's just Sonic. Got to go fast. Got to go fast. Febby has the Observer ward. And Orb of Venom as well. Okay, let's see what they do here. So it will be Teehee Pugna mid. No funny shenanigans just yet. I'll have Raven Chaos Knight down to bot lane with Winter G's Small Sun. Down a bot with a Visage as well. What is Orange doing? Sam H is Nature's Prophet. That's probably his best hero. And usually teams do ban it out in the second phase up against them. He's just waiting around. And Forev just wants to see where the lanes are. Honestly, against TNC, it's the best thing to do. Just get this intel. Because you're never certain. You're never sure against TNC where they're going to throw these heroes.
30 seconds to battle.
especially with such
they
a funky draft.
They're gonna spot the majority though. Oh, good thing this new path's over here. Febby would be in some serious trouble.
Who's he being surrounded by? Yeah, he's fine. It's only a Dazzle and a Pogna. But going back to what we were saying during the draft, against an Ember Spirit, again, you are lacking stuns and disables, especially kind of instant target ones. I think this is going to come down to TNC, how fast they can push into these tier ones, and how quickly MVP can kind of react. Because MVP, in the games that I've seen them recently over the past, you know, week and a half, 2 weeks or so, they're very similar to TNC in the fact that laning stage doesn't matter a massive amount to them. They always know when they're strongest and when to kind of abuse their hero spells and, you know, when they can take objectives, taking fights and getting these pick-offs. So MVP will realize here that Void, Ember Spirit, OD, they need a good 20 minutes or so to really kind of, you know, hit their stride, get to that peak, or get to the first power spike for them, and then really start fighting. So it's going to be about, you know, dodging engagements, making sure that your defensive ward coverage is very good, looking for the... You know, making sure your communication is good as well, because a Nature's Prophet TP in to turn a tri-lane into a quad-lane could be devastating for them. Oh, Febby. Is he still going to be okay? They're trying to get the... He's dead, actually, isn't he? Poison Touch will slow him down and take him out. Pogna has a lot of base damage with that Null plus Fairy Fire as well. It does look like double Bounty Rune's going to go the way of MVP, though. So Febby gave his life for the greater good.
Worth. I don't know. Maybe. Who knows? Either way, I liked everything that you were talking about right there, though. Like, TNC, they just, same thing we said during the draft, they have a plan, and if there's one thing they love, it's, you know, forcing the other team to accommodate to them. Like, a lot of teams, I think, last pick there, they would have went with, like, a Queen of Pain to build an Orchid as a mid-hero that can help deal with the Ember Spirit. That would be your draft, and our game would start. But instead, TNC are the kind of team to say, all right, well, we're going to pick a Pogna. And we're just going to run at you. We're going to make you deal with us. We don't need lockdown for your Ember because he's going to be dealing with us. We're not dealing with him. Like, you need to stop us from taking all your tier 2s, getting Roshan, and coming high ground.
This Pugna's doing a great job mid, actually. Like, the level 1 OD isn't even sure what to level up. No Orb, no Astral. He's like, well, I've been blasted 4 times. The Pugna has, like, 500 mana and 85 mana cost on his spell. I'm just being right-click. Look at the damage. Teehee. Oh, the Fairy Fire and Salve both popped out by QO.
He's gonna have a bottle here in a second, too. So, well, what do you do? Because you can just fake out the Nether Blast. It's one of those abilities that Astral shouldn't do anything against.
Oh, T, he might have overstepped, though. They've got Febby coming in from the side, and that's gonna be a kill here for him. Even with the decrep, T, he's dead. Hello? Oh, God, you have fucked up.
Oh, that's unacceptable.
Oh, dear.
You can't do that.
Like that, there's no reason for Teehee to survive that. Like honestly, that's a situation.
The tower, honestly.
That's a situation where any player, like hands off keyboard, I'm dead. I'm just gonna, you know, wait until I respawn. But QO's positioning, Febby's positioning, they both backed up. Oh dear.
Well, that's just some Dota 2 action for you right there.
And this is just gonna. He's going to swing back around. You know, Teehee fills his bottle, gets another rune. Kiro has limited regen left in that shared tango. Febby luckily does get the bounty rune down the bottom lane, taking it away from the flappy arms of Visage. And that Orb of Venom actually slowing him down a fair amount as Febby gets a few more clicks in. Oh dear. Forev's doing pretty great at bot lane though. Leading in last hits up against the Chaos Knight, who honestly has great base damage. You know, sure enough, there is that big kind of difference, 55 to 85, whereas the 74 is 71 to 77 of Forev's Void. So I guess Forev does have a more consistent, easier way and better damage to deal with these last hits.
Yeah, well, they're looking to put a little bit more pressure. Like, first you're bringing your creeps to the mid lane, and now it's the Tornado. Twister Alley down here. So that should give me even more help. Enchantress is just, like, so great. Remember the last time she was popular? That was kind of her shtick. It was, like, sending the Harpies to the mid lane, you know? They'd show up, they'd do the thing, a little bit of zappy zap, and meanwhile she farmed the jungle the whole time, whereas now it's more like core role, where you're in the offlane actually harassing people, as well yourself as... Ferb goes a little bit deep there, but should be... Okay, they can't even capitalize on this, because, well, of course, one thing about Visage is that it's all burst damage, right, up against this new Faceless Void. So you can't really do anything unless you're killing him.
Jeez. Visage run. Visage hide. Is he actually dead here?
Yeah, he's dead.
They're gonna deny the little golem. Oh, he trees and he tangos, but it's not enough. Like it doesn't work that way anymore. So you don't get the double HP regen over the same time. It's now double the time, right?
I don't know. Is it? I don't recall that change.
I'm pretty sure that's how it changed. Oh, Febby stunned under tower, dead to tower hits. I'm pretty certain that's how they changed it. Because it used to be when
you... I believe you, Durka.
It used to be when you, like, tangoed an observer ward or one of those trees that you get...
Oh, yeah!
You get double the amount of HP regen per second over...
Yeah, now it just lasts twice as long. Yeah, you're correct. That's what the change was.
Yeah, so he was trying to do that little trick where it's like, I'm going to get loads of HP regen, but it doesn't work that way anymore, so... He kind of wastes the tree and... Oh my god, the branch! QO coming in to try and kill AU, but here we go! Tri-lane turns into quad-lane, and QO pretty screwed. Forever does not have his level 6. He's gonna have to time-walk himself back a little bit further to safety. That's a lot of commitment, though. Oh, Febby might be stuck as well. Touchable up to level 1, but the damage output here from TE body blocks through, and cooldown on blast is ridiculously low. He'll dodge the blast! Ooh! Hop, skip, and a jump! I think TE still gets this with Decrep up in 2. He's got Vision up on high ground with a creep.
Angle.
He's got the Decrep, but will he have the range for the damage? Blast not going to hit. Febby too fast. Oh boy.
I love Enchantress. Such an enjoyable hero. So much action, throwing creeps into lanes, sproinking around, boots, 380 move speed. What isn't there to love?
Crazy Radiant stuff. Meanwhile, the one lane we haven't looked at, the one lane that's kind of going well for MVP.
Yeah.
Ember Spirit free farming 30 and 5. Mental Protector is now pushing into this tier 1 with the help of Dubu. It's going pretty well for them. This offlane Nature's Prophet, you know, sure enough, he's got some last hits. He's looking pretty good. He hasn't died yet either. It's a free farm Ember Spirit when the trade off is Chaos Knight not getting a massive amount, you know, 15 and 1. He has half the last hits here of the Ember when really they should be winning all their lanes and looking to push into towers in the next 3 or 4 minutes.
I mean, Perev has 28 last hits. It's an offlane faceless void. He doesn't even have a Crumbling Blade.
Interesting. I mean, where's I guess Iron Talon is a good kind of comeback mechanism.
Oh,
and if
lane.
You're dominating your lane, why do you need a comeback mechanism? Yeah, you're right, Teehee. Caught, but the Decrep is there, and Febby might be the one in trouble with the Sprout. Sam H. Oh, what? Is he getting fogged?
Canceled.
The DD rune from Febby, time to turn? Nah. Doesn't have enough HP.
This is still getting chased down, but they'll give up.
They'll kill off the creeps, at least. Radiant's top tower has fallen. Oh, no they won't. The deny on the Centaur from the Alpha Wolf. Oh, dear. QO, it's a little bit balls deep. He's stolen a lot of int here with the final Sanity's Eclipse. Not enough! 65 HP. The Astral should finish him, though. And QO's making damn sure he dies.
Yeah, not this time.
I guess level 1 Astral. Yeah, it's not going to finish him. So he did need that final click in.
Well, now, in terms of the bottom lane, like, you have to be so scared as this Chaos Knight now. You can't just, like, sit up here the whole time. You can't continue the lane as normal because he is the Chronosphere. It's just, like, kind of the Omni Slash and Juggernaut, right? Like, it's such a long duration. Like, there's already the TP coming in now, but you can just Chrono and then someone can TP and you can still probably get the kill in this Chaos Knight. So, this lane is now a lost zone. And MP's just, like, running away from a Dazzle up here.
Dragon Creep wave across? Yeah, it's fine. So with the way these lanes are going, let's take a look at hero levels. That's pretty important. You know, Febby's been that distraction, the kind of recon hero running back and forth, died twice, is level 3. But she's kind of managed to keep the Visage and the Dazzle both at bay. You know, they've not been able to stack and pull efficiently or correctly just from the threat of this Enchantress coming into the jungle. Then you look at the levels of the cores, actually. 3 heroes level 7 over on MVP, while you're just hitting level 6 on heroes like the Chaos Knight. And Pugna is halfway through 6 as well. But I rarely look at net worth this early on. I kind of wait until, you know, 10 to 12 minutes to take a look at net worth, but I really want to see this faceless void. 3,400 at 8 minutes for an offlane void. You're looking at about the same for your safe lane Ember Spirit. It's insane amounts of farm.
Yeah, it really is. He'll dump that Chronosphere down onto Winter G Small Sun, so this will be his first kill as well, as if the game wasn't going good enough for him already. So he'll add that onto his tally here. But yeah, I mean, this is exactly what you need from this hero, because he's not one of those heroes that does very well from behind. Like, yeah, he's still an offlaner, and yeah, he's survivable, but honestly, you really want that early blink, and most people, of course, want to get the Vlads first, so you don't get that full initiating power until you have quite a bit of gold. And some teams like have even run them in like in a safe lane position, trying to do the same kind of idea with like a dual offlane to something else. But this is like ideal scenario. He ran him offlane. He had a hell of a time. He's gonna come online so early, and it looks like they're set up for a very good mid game.
Hey, we've even seen Syndrome run it the other day for State Gaming, where he realized, okay, I'm a void. I'm gonna have to go offlane, but they've got a defensive tri lane. Febby. Behind enemy lines, but he literally went jungle from level one.
He got like Iron Talon jungle.
Oh, were you casting that game with me? Maybe you
no,
were.
No. It's just that's what you have to do. I've seen it a few times.
Yeah, but he was like level four by 3 minutes 30 or something. Like it was. He's a great jungler with Iron Talon, but I guess who isn't? Honestly, that item's a little bit insane. Dubu,
yeah, it is a nice way of opening up the offlane, though. I gotta say, at first I was a hater, but I kind of like the way it opens up some hero pools, some heroes, invis here.
Good move speed there, but he's just going to get stuck, sent to another dimension. Qo has come in for the kill. Forev takes it. Sam H. They're going to try and kill off Qo here. They're going with the stun, the decrap, and blaster. There, they've got the OD. And maybe now Forev's face of Void is in a little bit of trouble. Except, no, just kidding. 6 second cooldown on Time Walk. No damage dealt. Running away. Jumping away. This Faceless Void is untouchable.
Is there a better scaling skill in the game than this right now? It goes from a 24 second cooldown on a ridiculous ability to a 6 second cooldown on a ridiculous ability.
I honestly don't know.
It might actually be the best scaling skill in Dota right now.
It has a mana cost of 40. Like, that's, like, cooldown aside, mana cost of 40 is insane. For something that negates all damage done to you in the past 2 seconds. Oh, Visage, are you in trouble? It looks like you are.
Yeah, Witch is having a rough game. Is he all the deaths? He is. Okay, there's one from Teehee, but he's the other four.
Well, it's really not what you want. Because, okay, in this situation, majority of the time, you want your Dazzle to be your hard five. You know, buying all your Obs wards, doing all the kind of... Raven. Phantasm gets the extra illusion there, but he's taking so much damage down. The Witch Doctor comes in with a Death Ward, and that Sandy's Eclipse is enough to take down Teehee as well, maybe here. Tries to drain out Forever, but he jumps himself away. The Witch Doctor, Buddha Restoration. Oh, plink, plink, plink from that Pugna. Little ward, but Forever can't find the Pugna. Over to the side. Yep, Dazzle's dead. Finally, Forever sees Teehee. Four down, a tier one. And this is a complete reversal of what we expected during the draft, you know? TNC were meant to get an early lead, push into towers, but it's MVP that have just outplayed and crushed every single lane.
Yeah, they went for the more standard laning, you know, just the Pugna mid in terms of like what we were kind of talking about with like weird dual lanes and everything. The Nature's Prophet, obviously you can't touch the Ember Spirit, who hasn't even been a part of these fights, by the way. He's 1-0-0 with boots of travel now, so now he might eventually show up here, but it's just the rest of the squad. Like, you can't give this Faceless Void that much, and the Visage, I guess, was just a major mistake. Like, died so many times, he just can't contribute anything against Forev whatsoever. What can you do? He just backtracks it. Well, time walks it, but... I should rename it to Backtrack, honestly. That would please me greatly. Like, you don't even go that far with it anymore. It's more Backtrack than it is Time Walk.
Yeah.
Everyone buys Blink Dagger. I should start a petition. It worked for, what was it, Cloak and Dagger? It was like the new permanent, was it permanent invisibility that got changed?
Oh, from Ricky.
Yeah, Reddit did it. I mean, can't I do it?
Are you Reddit? Skill name. Are you Reddit, though?
No.
Oh, they see the Visage. Good aggressive ward placed between tier 1, tier 2. But it's going to be Teehee that gets found here initially. Searing Chains and MP is all they need. Oh, they're going to kill multiple heroes here. One's dead, the secondary one up on the high ground. Forev chases down, just needs a bash. Needs to get in there with the damage, but they've got the cask and the death ward. Oh, it bounces back onto the Visage, and down he goes as well. 4-12 is the score, 13 minutes in, and I think this is getting close to game over, unless MVP, you know, make a massive mistake. Or a series of massive mistakes, even.
I mean, the road back is so hard for TNC. They don't have any of those tools of the videos you see or the games you've seen where the comebacks happen. Like, there's no massive AoE. There's the only way they win this game is a series of massive mistakes, as you said, by MVP, and then they have to capitalize on it through split pushing through a Nature's Prophet, like Phantasms. He needs like Drum's Armlet in the next 3.5 minutes or something. which just isn't going to happen in order to actually put enough damage to kill somebody on the side of MVP. And that's all while they have to deal with Chrono and a Mega Farmed Ember Spear just ratting the entire map.
10,000 net worth lead. Radiance 14 minutes in. We'll set the graphs off because it looks like TNC. Defensive weave up on themselves. Want to try and fight into this as Raven gets his Ogre Club delivered. Void. Forev. Up on the high ground. Oh, the time dilation is there, but Forev stunned up. Guess what? He can just take all that damage off him with a three-man Chrono here. Kask is bouncing back onto the supports. Forev slowed down a little bit. And QO doesn't want to go into this just yet. He's holding onto that Sandy's Eclipse until he gets a little more intelligence stolen. But Febby, he's just spronking around in the back end as Visage is dead. Just taken out by the Void. Finally, TNC got a kill onto that Witch Doctor, but it's just so distant from an actual teamfight victory. Forever just keeps jumping off onto high ground. He doesn't care. All that mana being returned back to him. QO does get a good Eclipse, but it's not a massive amount of damage. Finally, though, Mental Protector comes in with a DPS. In with a Flame Guard. Damage is here onto Raven as well. Teehee gone. An impetus out from Febby. And now they can secure that Roshan for themselves.
Man, Faceless Void is just like showing off to be so good here right now. Time dilation, man, cannot be undervalued. Like, the way it affects heroes like Chaos Knight, who love to throw out multiple stuns, you know, one of his big factors is you level up Reality Rift for that 6-second cooldown. I think he used it once that whole fight. Like, he got time dilated twice, he got Chronoed as well. There's just not a lot of, you know, space to do anything when you have to deal with that. And they did a really good job of being aware of the Pugna Ward too. Like, he saw QO like hesitating a bit during the Chronosphere. He kind of waited out. He was just trying like Q dumpster with the ulti. Like, they knew they could take the fight anyway, and in the end, they're still far ahead.
Poor little Visage. Buying all the wards. No medallion, no ags for him. And what we're looking at for the Dazzle actually, earn arcanes, an bracer. I guess this Pugna's gonna go for Aether Lens. He's building into it. Ring of Health plus Arcane Boots. Just needs the recipe now. But the Wrap-In MVP, they're ready to fight some more. They've taken down Tier 1s everywhere across the board. There's two Tier 2s standing still. But not for long. Not for long. QO has the Aegis Drums. He's tanky as all hell. I guess he'll go into a Full Staff or a Rod of Atos next. But Febby, the guy who was, you know, like 0-2 the first 5 minutes of the game, is super close to Aghanim Scepter.
Yeah, I mean, they've got four heroes on top of the net worth chart, so it's everyone's farmed at this point. Just complete map dominance. The Aetherlands you mentioned, have you seen the like hidden nether wards and everything from this now because of the range?
it's
kind of akin to like the death wards now for Aetherlands as well, so definitely a solid item. But will it be enough? I'm not too certain.
Forev's making a Manta style here, or an SNY. He's actually picked up a Yasha. And a Blink Dagger from QO. Okay. No Four Staff or Rod of Atos. Just go straight for the mobility. I guess against the Chaos Knight, mobility is great, you know? Try and dodge out Reality Rift, get yourself up to high ground somewhere. That's what Forever's been doing the majority of the time.
Yeah, that's kind of an odd choice. Like, I mean, he's rich enough that he can get Yasha and still have Blink in, like, a minute and a half if he really wants to. Which I feel like he would.
I guess the big thing for QO also is he can blink onto like the Nether Ward to take it out, blink past Chrono, get himself into a better position, decrep onto Visage, gonna keep him alive a little bit longer, Forev dropping low, but yeah, goodbye damage, time walks it all off, and Sam H is shredded by the OG. At this point, TNC, they're all cooped up inside their bases, the damage from MP is great, QO has Aegis, he can blink straight on in, looks for the kills, and Raven gonna fall shortly after. They're being dived. Tier 3s mean nothing to MVP. As Teehee, there's the blink again from QO. I think you just call it. But TNC have pride.
The kind of team to not do that. They always seem to let it ride out. A lot of the time, they'll just kind of sit in. You know, oh come on, end it the old-fashioned way. We'll be here waiting.
We shall not surrender. We will be here until our throne is dead. Sam H. You are certainly dead, my friend. QO, again, just blinking forward aggressively. He's got a secondary life. He doesn't care. The pure damage from Enchantress and the Outworld Devourer is just too much to get past here as TNC I mean, honestly. I mean,
they
hello?
Don't call GG that much, but I'm expecting Winter to just do it. I'm like done with this game, man. I have 8 deaths on Abyss and just get me out of here.
He's putting his familiar. Look, he's. Microed his familiar into the tower. Oh, he's moving it now. He managed to actually put the familiar inside the tower, which I thought was kind of cute. Well, one Rax has fallen 18 minutes in, and MVP just looking to kind of see. Oh. Whoa, oh, QO. QO is.
Is it the SNY build? A classic.
I think he's making Manta style, honestly. I don't know why, but.
I mean, they've already got one up on Forev.
Oh, goodness gracious me.
I guess it makes sense for D-Crab.
Yeah. Well, Sam H. Did he just TP in there?
Dead. No, he was just kind of like chilling in there.
Poor TNC. One last fight for them. They've got Phantasm. Right, if only CK was level 11.
Yeah, that's pretty huge deal. Or had a completed item would also be great. That would be the ideal
Radiant's
scenario, I think.
Tower is under attack.
Oh, give me a sand. Give me anything. A horse. A victory for my horse. Chaos Knight, just give your mount away. Aegis is finally gone, so MVP do not have that fallback on the OD anymore. But yeah, Sand and Yasha. The good old OD Sand and Yasha. Now, I'm a big advocate of this build, you know. I've tinkered with Intelligence Heroes going SNY. One of my favorites was Mid Lion with Sand and Yasha. It's super good.
I mean, it doesn't give you any of the, you know, mana pool increase or int items in general in terms of doing anything for your hero, but I don't know. Seems pretty popular. Had a couple people going for it at the MDL, I do believe. You've shown up a few times. Might be the next big thing, guys. Watch out.
Watch out for the OD with SNY.
With the blink Radiant's drums SNY OD. Hide your pubs. Alright.
Yeah, Agonim's for Scepter.
Final countdown. The Nether Ward's down, so that's like the end of this fight.
Ah, the Nether Ward's gone. They just go up and kill it off. Go forward to the Searing Chains. Forev's looking for something. He doesn't have a chrono, but I don't even need it. The Grave onto Sam H will keep him alive a little bit longer. They've managed to take out the Witch Doctor on the back, and now the drain comes from Teehee. Oh, Reality Rift. Jumped away. Ember Spirit had a remnant available. Just going to regen himself back up. The Chrono go down onto 3, and QO, he's got the hammer. He's going to drop it and takes down both of them. Raven is now without mana, without life, and without a home to go back to. His GG is called MVP Phoenix. I mean, that just looked too easy.
Yeah, that's one way to put it. The lanes just broke down. Like, we talked about how you would think that they would have an advantage in the laning phase from TNC, but that Faceless Void just proved to be too difficult to deal with just the Visage to back up the Chaos Knight. They never really felt like they could get on top of him, you know? There was no, like, stun, even an attempt into, like, some burst damage or anything like that. It just couldn't be done with Febby. Like, yeah, he was a low level, but he was moving around the map, make stuff happen. And Enchantress, Faceless Void, two heroes that are already pretty high in terms of the meta, but MVP just showing them off a little bit higher. And Ember Spirit, you can't even analyze that for this game. Like, you're total free firm. Like, you can't win a game if the Ember Spirit gets total free firm.
I mean, MP was kind of just there, you know? He PvE'd for the first 20 minutes and was like, oh, you guys are fighting around Roshan? I'll come and join. I'll come and help. I'll do some things. So now, because of how quick that game was, we do have a pretty long break. 45 minutes until MVP go up against Execration. Yeah, Execration. We'll see if we can get that game pushed a little bit earlier, though. Obviously, MVP are free. They're ready. They'll go for a little break. Let's see if we can get Execration into the lobby and ready to start soon. So, you know, could be a 45-minute break, could be 15. Not entirely sure. I'll try and let you guys know.
But could it be 1 minute?
It cannot be 1 minute.
Okay, so
I know TNC will want... I know MVP will want to have a little break, you know. Celebrate their victory there. Pretty big for them. Pretty big for them in the group stage. But we'll be back in a short while. I'll keep you guys updated with what we're up to.
But not a minute short?
Oh my god. I'm going to kill you. I'm going to come to Canada. I'm going to pour maple syrup over you and light you on fire. Wait, maple syrup's flammable, right?
Sure, why not? It's got sugar in it. We'll go with it.
We'll find out. See you guys in a bit.
You do burn calories. So.
Oh, God. Let's make it stop.